Today, two different geometric logo designs that you can make with the Blend tool that are guaranteed to spark your interest and your inspiration to the next level. Making today's video possible is monday.com, which is an awesome team management tool. The platform itself is suitable for any size team, from two freelancers working together up to thousands collaborating across the globe. Monday.com is a major asset to managers, and learn more about it later in today's video to boost productivity and collaboration within your business. Now, I do love the Blend tool in Illustrator, and here are two simple ways to make two neat geometric logo designs. So firstly, let's make sure we have just a stroke selected in the color palette, and then choose a fairly small stroke weight. You then need to locate the polygon tool here. Once selected, hold down Shift and then click and drag to create a polygon shape. And whilst you have the Shift held down, press the up and down arrows on your keyboard until you have six sides on your shape. Now, throughout today's Blend tool logo design tutorial, make sure that you have the scale stroke settings activated in the preferences window. This is going to help every shape that you make have the same stroke weight scaled up or down. Copy your hexagon with Command or Control C, and then paste a duplicate with Command or Control F. Hold down Shift and the Alt Option key at the same time, and then click and drag to scale up the new hexagon, like I'm doing here. Now rotate the new shape by 45 degrees, and I think it's a really cool effect to have the two hexagons nearly touching, like I have on my screen now. But of course, you can experiment with different shapes for your logo design, and today's tutorial is to spark your inspiration. When ready, locate the Blend tool here, and then click both shapes directly over the stroke lines. Now hold down the Alt Option key and then click again. You can now select the Specify Steps option and experiment with different amounts of steps with the preview box checked. Next, for this first geometric logo, let's expand the shape here and then open up the Pathfinder window. There is a neat little trick that's going to allow you to edit the stroke weight if you so wish. So once you've expanded your design, you can then use the Exclude option in the Pathfinder window, which is now going to allow you to edit the stroke weight if you're not satisfied with your logo design. Finally, we can then outline the stroke in the top drop-down menu and add a color or a gradient to the design. Of course, you can experiment with different kinds of gradients that you want to apply in your design. Pressing G for the gradient tool allows you to control the direction of the gradient across the entire design. Now we're going to move on to the second geometric logo design that you can make using the Blend tool. For this logo, select the star tool and then click on the artboard just once. We want to use 4 points on our star, and you want to make the top radius around 3 or 4 times larger than the bottom one. Once created, you should have a shape similar to mine here. Like we did before in the first geometric logo, copy it with Command or Control C and then paste a duplicate with Command or Control F. Resize the duplicate by holding down Shift and the Alt Option key at the same time. Make sure to set your stroke weight relevant to your design, and then grab the Blend tool as you did before. Again, we're going to use the Specify Steps function. Experiment with different amount of steps, and see what your Blend function can produce. Now, I really like the second logo, but they're both pretty cool in their own right. So now, go ahead and expand your design and add your color or your gradient. From here, I suggest that you build up your designs using multiple different shapes, or just play around with the Blend tool in this technique. It can be used to make some very, very interesting geometric logos or minimal logo designs. I've had lots of fun making a video and designing geometric logo designs using the blend tool. You can make these for fun, or even implement them into your workflow and your business designs. And if you are part of a business or a team or a company, you should take a look at the team management tool Monday.com. Monday.com is a centralized platform for teams to manage every detail of their work. From high-level roadmap planning to the specifics of day-to-day tasks, whilst building a culture of transparency. It's simple and flexible enough to meet the needs of just two people working together, as well as a vastly complex workplace operation involving thousands of people spanning different departments in different time zones. It really is beneficial for the inner workings of a business to run that much smoother and more quickly, with an easy to use and attractive interface. It's available on both desktop and mobile devices, so check it out for yourself down in the description box below. And of course guys, until next time, design your future today. Peace.